We started working together about 3.5 years ago in Sacramento. Jim had been performing, 25 years or so in Sacramento, and I was new to the area. It's my hometown, but I hadn't lived there for a while. So I went to a jam session, and I came up to the pianist beforehand, because I'd never performed on stage with a live band at that point. And so I went up to him, and I said, this is my music. I hope this will work. And
she looked a little nervous.
A little nervous. Uh-huh. But it went great, mm-hmm. and it was just a wonderful start. And at that point, I needed to have some musicians to work with, and he had a wonderful group that he was working with, but didn't really have a vocalist at that point.
You know, I knew she had talent right away, and I said to her after the gig, I said, hey, let's work together and work up some music and some charts for you. And she said, okay, and it's kind of the history of how we started together. We started the Doris Day Show basically because we were doing our casuals around Sacramento, and we had probably up to 20, maybe more than that, people come up to us after our gigs and say, you know, your singer kind of reminds me of Doris Day. And I said, yeah, I can kind of see that girl next door look kind of a thing. And she sings great. So I looked at Laura and I said, I think that's our cue. We probably ought to do a tribute to Doris Day. And we both agreed.
Yeah, we really did. It was something that we never sought out to do until we kept getting this feedback from people in the audience. And we both loved Doris Day. Jim was a very big fan of her movies and music, as was I. So it was a natural fit for us to pursue something like this. Yes, lots of research. I really wanted to add to the show more than just the music. I wanted to be able to share stories about her career and her life. And there are lots of interesting stories about the songs, the movies they come from, her impressions of those movies and songs. And I wanted to be able to share all of that with the audience. So I threw myself into that type of research and learning all that I could about her as a person and as an actress and singer. And Jim threw himself into learning about her music.
You know, Doris she recorded over 600 songs. And I went through almost every one of them. And I would find we covered all of her basic number one hits, but we also covered some of the beautiful obscure songs that a lot of people really didn't know. And I would send one to Laura over email and say, check this song out. And she'd say, I think that's a good one, let's try that. And write up a chart for her. And I tried to keep it as close to the original that I could do, but still we could inflect our originality as a combo, jazz combo, and kind of give it our own originality.
When I was researching about Doris Day, I learned that she had actually a difficult childhood, which you might not expect from someone who radiated such positivity. But a lot of people didn't realize that she did have a difficult childhood. But what I really admired about her was that she didn't let that stop her from being a positive person. She brought that to all of her roles. She worked really hard. I admired that a lot when I learned about her, that every co-star she worked with, every director, everyone that was interviewed said she was always prepared. She worked hard. She was just a joy to be on set with. And I really liked that. You know, I liked learning that the person that I admired and idolized was as lovely in person as I would hope for her to be.
Mm-hmm. You know, I've had the chance to speak to her on the phone probably about a dozen times now in the last year. And I have to tell you, it's absolutely like talking to the way Laura and I are talking right now at this speed and tempo. It's amazing. She's just a fun person to talk with, and she's funny, and she laughs, and it's just it's an amazing experience.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And she's incredibly gracious. Mm-hmm. Whenever we share with her stories that people will tell us after our shows, it's one of my favorite part of our shows is people will come up to us afterwards and share stories about her music and how she touched them personally. And I love that part of what we do. And then I will write emails and sharing that with Doris. And she will express back to us, because Jim does the same thing, and how much she appreciates her audience, how much she still loves everybody, and how touched she is that people still remember her so fondly and have all these wonderful stories and memories of her in their youth. And I love that part.
Yeah. I think that we're jazz musicians, so we love playing jazz. We love playing Doris Day's music. And I think we're recreating something that people come and kind of takes them back to yesteryear.
Well, I love that part of it. I love bringing the music to people who grew up with it and rekindling those memories for them. And nobody leaves our show without a big smile on their face.
Right.
Because it brings back all these memories for them. Mm-hmm. And I also love it when we have younger folks in the audience who didn't grow up with Doris Day, who appreciate the music as well, yeah, just because it's great music.
Right.
So even if you didn't grow up with these memories of her movies, mm-hmm, and her music, you can still appreciate the music that is being played. And I love exposing a whole new audience, mm-hmm, to Doris Day.
Absolutely. So last May of 2009, Sacramento has a big jazz festival. And we were at a previous venue, so we had to run to the next set. As we get there to the ballroom at the Holiday Inn,
we were doing a set in tribute to Doris Day.
Right, and there was about 500 and some people waiting for us to go on.
Mm-hmm.
I walk in, we got 10 minutes to spare. A woman comes up to me and says, "Jim, you have to come meet my sister. She has something special for you." And I said, "Okay," looking at my watch. Walk over to her, and her sister's name is Barbara. And Barbara says, "Jim, I have something for you from Doris Day." I said, "You're kidding." She goes, "I work for Doris." And she pulled out of her bag an 8 by 10 picture of Doris signed for me. And it said, "Jim, thanks for the tribute. Love Doris Day."
Love Doris Day.
That's right. Uh-huh.
She loves that part.
She loves me. And I was excited, and I thought, this is the best thing in the world. And then she pulls out her cell phone out of her pocket, and she says, "Doris wants to say hi to you. I'm going to call her right now." And I about hit the floor. Unfortunately, I had 5 minutes to get on to get the band ready. So I went and I said, "Go find Laura and she'll talk to Doris. She'd love it." And you tell the rest of the story.
Well, so Jim's mother comes up to me, mm-hmm, all excited and says, "You've got to take this phone call, Laura. You have to take this phone call." And I'm thinking, "Mrs. Martinez, what? Who's on the phone?" And she said, "Doris Day is on the phone."
Mm-hmm.
And I thought someone was yanking my chain. I thought there's no way that Doris Day could be on this phone. Mm-hmm. But I answered the phone and you can immediately recognize, mm-hmm, her voice.
Absolutely.
It still sounds like her to this day. And she's 86, mm-hmm, now. She was, mm-hmm, 85 then.
Mm-hmm.
She just sounded fantastic. And, mm-hmm, she was so excited about what we were doing and, mm-hmm, so thankful and gracious. Mm-hmm. And then it was, you know, I really wanted Jim to have the opportunity, mm-hmm, to talk,
right,
to her.
Right.
But Jim's mom got the phone first, and she got, yeah, on the phone with Doris Day,
yeah,
tracked Jim down, mm-hmm, to get on the phone. And it was time to start. You know, we had a certain time, and we had all these hundreds of people waiting for us to start playing. So I jumped onto the stage to explain to everybody why we were delayed. And I said, "Well, you'll never believe who Jim is on the phone with right now. It's, mm-hmm, Doris Day."
Right.
And you could hear the gasps and the oohs and ahs in the audience.
Right.
So
my mom talked to her first, and then you spoke to Doris, right?
No, I talked to Doris first.
And you gave it to my mom.
And then your mom took it to you.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Between them and my mom's surprise, I even got a word
in. I'm surprised you did. But he did.
Yeah.
And then we got everyone in the audience. I got on the mic to explain, mm-hmm, why we were delayed,
mm-hmm,
and I orchestrated everybody in singing, saying, "Hello, Doris." And then we put the microphone up to the phone so you could hear her reaction, and she was choked up and emotional and, mm-hmm, so thankful and gracious,
yep,
and it was a special moment. And this was over a year ago, mm-hmm, and we were just back at the Jubilee, mm-hmm, this past May,
mm-hmm,
and we had people come up to us and say, "We remember last year, oh, that,
yeah,
was the highlight of,
yeah,
our Jubilee,"
yeah,
was hearing Doris Day.
Well, we're really looking forward to meeting everybody and having a great time together. What's wrong with that?
That was good.
Okay.
Want me to do it again?
Yeah, okay, it's good.
Oh, we're done? We're all done for real?